Hey girls, hi Vlog a Latte. It's been a while. I can't remember if I just missed one or if I missed 2 weeks. Is this recording? Yes. I just can't even remember, which just goes to show just how out of it I've been. Just trying to get through the year teaching. Almost done, actually. I have 3 more weeks, including this week. So that's a good thing. I got my master's this past weekend. I graduated with my master's, which is amazing. There's just been a lot of things that I've been juggling and everything. And yeah, so I'm sorry for missing my Vlog Latte video, possibly videos. I guess it was just one, and then we decided that we were all gonna not do it this past week. I think that's what it was. I can't remember. Out of it, yes, out of it. I almost missed the video again, but I just realized it is, yeah, it's 10:40 p.m. right now, and I'm going to bed, and I remembered I didn't make my video, and I was like, oh, I can't miss again, I have to post a video, but I'm not sure if my computer is working right now. I haven't tried it in about a week or so. I have been using a computer that is given to me by my school that I teach at, so I have had a computer, but my real computer, the internet wasn't working for, every single day the internet wasn't working. So I'm kind of worried about that because, it's going to make it really hard to post videos if my internet's not working. So obviously I'm going to need to get a new computer very soon. Probably will get one. I don't know exactly when I'm gonna get one, but June or July. So that's why I'm posting this from my phone, and this is just a great video, isn't it? I don't remember what everyone's videos were about because I watched them, seems like weeks ago now. But I do remember that Kat talked about prom, and I was really surprised that a lot of you didn't go to all of your school dances. I went to all of my school dances, pretty much. I don't think I ever missed one, but I could be wrong, but I don't think I ever missed one. Not the big ones, for sure. Our school had, some more casual dances. We had, an 80s dance every year and stuff, where you just, wore, 80s clothes and stuff. So I may have missed some of the more casual things, but all the big, we had homecoming every fall, which is, basically prom, but not, but then only the seniors got prom, and so it was homecoming every year, and then the seniors got prom as well, which was in the spring. I went to all those dances, really enjoyed it. I didn't have dates, except I did have a date for my first homecoming 9th grade year during those, random 2 months where I had a boyfriend. We've talked about that before. And then I had a date to prom, but it was really just, a mutual friend of a friend or whatever. We were going, we had planned, a group of people to go as a group of friends, and we were, the ones that didn't have dates, so we just went together. So it worked out all right, although I kind of really wished that we weren't, dates on that day, because I didn't really want to hang out with him. I wanted to hang out with, other people, but I felt a little bit obligated to hang around him, but I also didn't follow through with that obligation very well, and I kind of left him a lot, and I was a horrible date, basically, is what happened that day, but I did apologize to him later for being a horrible date, because I felt bad about it, but yeah. So, I definitely learned that day that it's not worth it to have a date that you, either one, I'm sure it'd be great if you were, good friends, but it's not worth it to have a date that you're not even friends with. Not worth it at all. I would have much rather not had a date, to be honest. But it was nice, for the sake of taking pictures and everything, to not feel like, oh, I don't have a date, I had one for the pictures and everything, so that was nice, but anyways, I can't remember what else I was supposed to talk about. I just really wanted to post this video so that I had a video posted. I am super excited because Tomorrow is basically like my last day of like teaching, in a lot of ways. We're finishing Romeo and Juliet tomorrow with my freshmen, and we have a test on Thursday, and then really like we're watching Romeo and Juliet the movie. Like it's gonna take like 4 days or something, and they have a bunch of awards assemblies and stuff, and then we review for exams, and then we have exams, and basically that's the end of the year. So tomorrow is basically like the last day of like forcing these students to try to listen to me when they refuse to, and being ignored and humiliated and whatever. After that, it's gonna be a lot of like relaxed days. So I can get through tomorrow. I'm pretty much through the year, so that's great. And what I'm more worried about is then cleaning my classroom and getting it back to the way it was when I first moved into it, and cleaning my house and moving out of my house and everything. That's gonna be the real adventure. But I do have some really good news that I got today. So my boyfriend is currently living with his grandma and his sister, my boyfriend JP, and he is planning to move out and get his own apartment and whatever, because I'm moving to South Carolina. You all know this, but the plan is for me to move in with his grandma and his sister, and that way I don't have to bring furniture, I don't have to bring anything but myself and my clothes and like my books or like whatever. And so super excited. I was worried that it wasn't going to work out because his granny lives in sort of a retirement community, but basically it's just like a normal old neighborhood. They just have a little bit more rules about some things, and it's really quiet and nice and everything. And so he had to get permission from his landlord, or like ask if it would be acceptable if I could like move in, and everything. And I was really nervous that maybe they'd be like, oh, wait, she's not technically family. No, this is not okay. But they weren't. They're like, absolutely, that's totally great. As you know, as long as everybody's happy, that's fine. Like, go ahead. So I'm so happy. So I officially know where I'm going to be living, and I'm so happy. Like, I literally started like crying when he told me. I was so happy. I've been so worried about it for so long. So I know it seems like such a small thing to be so worried about, but I was like so happy. Ah, so anyways, I'm really happy. I know that I get to live where I want to live and not have to get my own apartment and start over again, because I'm not planning to bring furniture with me from Texas. And so I just like I was so dreading possibly having to get my own apartment and start over from scratch. And I just really need a year where I don't have to do that. I just did that this year, and it's been a really awful year living alone. And so I just am really happy that I'm not gonna be living alone, and I'm going to have JP's granny and his sister there with me. And oh, I just can't wait to have family, a new family. You know, I'm obviously, I don't need to get into this all over again. Obviously, I'm very upset to be leaving my family, but I know that this is the path that my life is on right now, and I'm so very happy and thankful. And that's what happens when you love somebody and you're gonna get married to them. So, yeah. Okay. All right. Goodbye, girls. I will see you guys later. Bye!